Amen.
What's up, you guys? POP, it's the place to be. So subscribe to me, and I'm back with another video with these pieces of Chris.
What's up? What's good? What's lit, YouTube fam? This is Lulu Pop, and I'm back with another video. Take heat, fuck me, nigga.
Gigi,
my name is Abby.
Alrighty, so you guys ask those questions and we're gonna eat. We're just gonna eat food and answer questions and then. So let's get into the video. The first question: what are you going to miss the most about OPA? My course director, Mr. Rami.
Okay.
A G, no cap.
Him.
And then.
Him.
Mr. Sullivan. Nobody else really. I don't think.
Is that what we're gonna miss about LPA?
The most. Oh.
Oh, the assemblies. The assemblies were funny, bro. Those were like funny, low-key.
How does it feel to know that you have to graduate online? I feel very sad, but
life goes on.
Life goes on, and. It's sad, but I'd rather be safe in my house than like be outside
and exposed to the corona
and exposed to coronavirus.
Coronavirus.
Because no, ma'am, that's not it. So, I mean, like, yeah, I'm sad, but at the end of the day, I'd rather be safe than sorry.
Period.
So. That's how I feel about the situation.
Y'all, this is good, right?
Mm-hmm. It's good.
It's good. Okay.
Like, this sauce.
And I'm getting that kick in the back of my throat.
Yeah. This one is, how has the coronavirus affected your life? And how do you plan to come out of this on top or better? Now, everyone can answer this question.
You start first.
What was it again? Okay, so it's two questions basically. So we're gonna.
So this is the first one, yeah.
How has the coronavirus affected your life?
It hasn't really affected my life because I'm fortunate to still go to my job and work. I know a lot of people had to get laid off because they couldn't work anymore. So I'm grateful to even make some, like even get like some hours, you know? So, I mean, it hasn't really affected my life except for not going to school. And That's the most it's affected me.
It affected my social life. That's about it. I don't really have one, but I miss my teacher. That's about it. Like, I really miss my teacher, my course director.
For me, I think it basically affected me to see the way how the world, how America treats its people.
Oh. Mm.
So it kind of shows.
Facts.
It opened up my eyes more to see, like, they low-key don't really care about us.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like survival of the fittest.
Yeah.
It's like, especially like in the healthcare field, like a lot of people don't have masks, a lot of people like going inside COVID patients' rooms with no masks, or you know, like they don't have the right mask.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot of stuff that has been eye-opening.
And also like for my mom, she's like a nurse. And so literally like, she'll have like how many is it, mommy? Like six?
Nine
gowns a day?
She'll have like nine patients and have to use that one gown for all
for
nine
the whole,
COVID
for all,
patients.
Yeah, for the whole 12-hour shift. And that's like
for the entire shift.
That's like cross contamination, and that's just very scary because. And the worst part is the nurses can't even get tested for coronavirus.
No.
They don't have enough tests.
That's
and also, did you guys hear that like some of the tests are like corrupt?
Yeah.
Like they're not good. Mm-hmm. That's just like so.
Mm-mm.
That's crazy. Spicy.
And then the second part of the question is, how do you plan to come out of this on top or better?
Mm.
I had the answer, but then I lost it.
Come back, Abby.
I don't know. I just know I'm gonna thrive in school, online school, especially because I don't have to see people. And I'm gonna do what I gotta do.
I don't know, I feel like this is the time now, like you're on, you know, stay at home orders or whatever. This is the time now, like whatever you're doing, like if you're in school for something, like go ahead and grab a book. Like, this is a time now to be able to, like, learn.
Get it done.
Yeah. You procrastinated and stuff, but actually,
you got time.
You got time. You all sit. The 24 hours in the day. Yeah, you can nap and stuff, but at least, like, open a book.
You sitting at home doing nothing all day, especially if you're not working. Come on. That's, like, grind time. Yeah. And that's just, like, a reminder to me to, like, just do better and, like, work harder and don't be lazy in everything I do.
Yep. This one is, how did your plans change due to the coronavirus?
The only plans that I had was for prom, graduation, but we're still having it. Oh!
You didn't have fall.
Listen, you guys, if you guys know, I love me some Russ, okay? Russ is like one of my favorite rappers. So we're supposed to go to a bus concert on May 22nd. But due to the corona, you know, I couldn't go. I was really disappointed because, like, wow. That would have been my first concert.
It's still gonna happen, though.
To someone. Yeah, I know, but, you know, still.
Way later.
To someone like that, like, actually, like listening to.
I didn't really have no plan. I just didn't want to party. Graduation party. I really didn't want one.
Yeah. You did or you didn't?
Didn't. And I guess they were gonna do something else for me, but I guess that stopped it, but I just really don't care. As long as I'm alive.
Amen.
I didn't really have any plans, but I was gonna plan something for my birthday. My birthday is May 21st. I didn't know what I was gonna do, but I'm bummed out that I'm not gonna be able to do what I wanna do, even though I don't know what I wanna do. What are your plans after COVID settles down?
Go to school. Hopefully, like, if
I wanna go on a trip.
If this finishes by like the beginning of next year, hopefully I have my AA so I can start on my bachelor's.
Since I'm working during the coronavirus, I want to be able to go on a trip.
For free. America need to provide us a trip for free. For free. Especially the Nessies.
Period.
Because the Nessies,
If you're watching this and you're a nurse, we love you. We love you.
Period.
LPNs, RNs, CNAs.
All of them.
All of them.
All of that.
It says, spill the tea. Who's better? Regular, full dual/regular IB kids. Let's be honest.
Discriminate.
Yeah.
You don't discriminate.
So, I mean,
they always chill.
Everybody was like, our class was like pretty, like.
Class 2020 is cool.
Yeah, chill. So, I think that there's like everyone. There's no tea, sweetie. Sorry.
Ain't no tea.
To burst your bubble. There's no tea.
That far.
She was cooler than me, you guys.
What's the best food at LPA and what's the worst food at LPA?
Okay. Bruh, the best food, like one of the best foods were like Nacho Day,
but I like the curly meat.
And then curly fried it, when we had like a la carte, bruh.
Oh, a la carte was the best.
Not now.
That's sad. A la carte had all the best foods. If they had kept a la carte in high school, that would have been the best. It was like wings, fries,
curly fries.
Ooh. Curly fries, pizza. But it was like all like good quality food. Oh, and I will say the little mozzarella sticks that they be having.
Oh, Bosco sticks.
And then the worst foods at LPA.
Oh, Microwave rice, macaroni, the fried chicken.
I remember in I remember in high school, I mean middle school, they like the kids used to get the big cookies, like when they were like, when they used to be big, they used to get the cookies and put milk in like the like the little plastic like in the Saran wrap that it came in.
When Michelle Obama was the first lady, our food changed in school. So we had a la carte, that stopped, and then we got nasty food.
Oh, my bad.
Very nasty, quote unquote, healthy food, but they're all coming from a can. That's not healthy. I'm sorry.
Yeah, like the buns. The buns used to be like,
soft, like so a baby's booty soft.
Mm-hmm. And now they're like
hard.
They were like, they're like wheat. Like wheat buns.
Ain't nothing wrong with the wheat. Yeah. At least make it good quality wheat.
Yeah. That's all we asking for.
Yeah. When she was the first lady, we had cookies, right? Our cookies were freshly baked. Like, they were good. Like, they're like this size.
Uh-huh.
And as the years went on, they got smaller.
They got smaller, and then they got doughier. And they taste like, there's this one time I was like, why would you try to sell this to people?
In middle school, they were a dollar, like, and like, you got what you paid for. But now, 75 cents seems questionable. Like,
that's how you know it was nasty.
Yeah.
Best subs in high school.
Okay.
Substitute teachers.
Our best sub was Gucci Man.
I feel like I'm Gucci Man in 2006.
Oh, we're forgetting someone. Mr. McCann.
Mr. McGann.
He's the GOAT.
He was chill.
That's his name?
Like, we call him
Gucci. Because that's all he wears.
We don't know what his name is. I don't know. I'm
dead. I mean, that's all he wears, though.
That's all he wears, though. It's Gucci. Yeah. It's like, literally.
He got money.
It's Gucci. It's Gucci.
He said he subbed just to do it. Like,
he just does it. Like, doesn't
yeah.
I know we in this quarantine predicament, but we should all be grateful God has something, even if he took something else away. How do you feel God blesses you?
I passed my class, like, and it was really hard. Like, when I tell you, college for me, college history was hard. It was hard. The first one, I almost didn't make it. The second history class, it ain't nothing but God. Like, if God won't do it, it won't get done. That's it.
Yeah, I feel that. Like, I almost failed, like, one of my... I remember, like, crying over, like, one of my classes. I didn't really almost cry. So, I just...
Especially online. If you're not, like, an online student, you're not used to it. So,
yeah.
Like...
But, yeah, so, like I was just, like, so thankful that I passed that class. Because I thought I was going to fail it and I should pay for the class. Cause you know how doing alone is, yeah, like the class, stuff like that, like go through this whole thing, and then like, I just didn't want to go through that, so I just thank God that I passed that class. I thank God that I'm alive because a lot of people are passing away, and it is very scary.
Yeah.
The I don't know, it's just like people that like not said like you wouldn't think would die, but like, you know, so
it's
soon,
very,
like
yeah,
it's just like
it's
so
soon and unexpected.
Weird.
Unexpected.
Yeah, so it's just like, wow. God blessed me with a roof over my head, bro. Clothes on my back.
That
and
part?
Two parents,
one
man.
Country.
People that support me.
Hey, I got one parent, but she right by my side.
Shut up.
Period.
Shut up to you.
Yep.
Perfect.
Yep.
Yeah.
I just thank God that he has brought me to a level. Like, quarantine has ruined my eyes. Back to the other question, too.
That part.
He has brought me to a level where, like, this is, like, life.
I'm just gotta keep going, like, and
also,
life's not often to be, life
not
is not
gonna
be rainbows and sunshines all the time. You know?
Yeah.
But this is a good way to connect with God, too.
And to, like, and to also, like, see what, like, you take for granted every day. Driving a car every day, going out, you know, to places and stores every day, all that, you know. Like, stuff that, like, the smallest stuff we take for granted. Going outside, like, who would have thought we can't even go outside? And if we do have to wear a mask, like, stuff like that, like, you know?
It's also amazing how good God is. Good God is.
What?
Because I feel like he planned this quarantine so that the world could, like, you know, revamp itself.
Yep.
You had all these problems going on with the world. You had, like, mm-hmm. the stuff with the ozone layer, the ice stuff.
The polar ice. That just goes to show you that, like, we're really mistreating what we have.
Our planet.
Yeah, like, the planet, where we live, like, that's crazy. For some people, they'll see it as, like, oh, like, this is, like, a lesson, you know, to learn stuff like that. Other people won't.
Yeah.
All right, you guys, if you like this video, like, share, comment, and subscribe for more content.
Bye.
I'm back with another banger.